joyful, conflicted, modern, laid back. This film does not know what it really wants to be.
Myself, Shakuntala.
Hi everyone, welcome to First Cut Reviews. Today I'm gonna be reviewing the new Prime Video release, Shakuntala Devi. I really don't know kitne logon ne Shakuntala Devi ka naam pehle suna hua hai. I think as for me, I had just heard her name pehle, but mujhe itna idea nahi tha ke who she really is. Because I, to some extent, am from the mathematical background. So, this lady, first of all, let me be very clear before I review the film. I am extremely happy that Indian filmmakers are picking up stories that are so inspiring. Is case mein mujhe nahi pata inspiring ka kya, but oh my god, what a talented genius this lady was. So the film starts with a very suspenseful moment. We have Shakuntala Devi's daughter in London going to file a criminal case against her mother. Aisa kya hua hai? Filing a criminal case against your mother. That too a world famous mathematician. That is where the film starts and it stops then and there to leave you in that suspense ke aisa kyun hai. We are immediately transported to Shakuntala Devi being 5 years old. And that is where the first revelation of her being that genius is actually shown to us. And this 5-year-old girl has shown to be such a prodigy that 5 साल की एज में आई थिंक बच्चों को गिनती ही मुश्किल आती होती है. क्यूब रूट का मतलब क्या है वो भी नहीं पता होता. बट दिस गर्ल कैन कैलकुलेट क्यूब रूट्स ऑफ 8 or 9 डिजिट नंबर्स जस्ट बाय लुकिंग एट देम. वियर्ड, काफी वियर्ड. बट या दैट इज व्हाई इट इज अ स्टोरी दैट नीड्स टू बी टोल्ड. उसके बाद द मैथमेटिक्स ग्रोज. We see her family, how the family is dealing with it. She, from her very small age, starts doing mathematics shows. And her family is now earning through her. So she is the real bread earner of the family. She dreams of going to school. But her father feels ke tu school se kya sikhegi? Tu hi school ko wapas sikha degi. Makes sense. But she can look at huge numbers and just do mental calculations and give you answers within seconds. Anu Menon, the director of the film, is a bit confused though. Because she just does not want to focus on the genius this lady was, but wants to delve deeper into her life as a biopic, as a story. The way Anu Menon tries to portray Shakuntala Devi comes out to be pretty negative, because she is shown to be extremely high-headed, but that is probably something that I like about the way she tries to describe the characteristics of Shakuntala Devi. I can imagine a lady in 1950s who is able to astonish an entire audience in front of her. A lady doing something like that on stage would be high-headed, would feel that she can rule the world. Things between Shakuntala Devi and her mother begin to go estranged. And that is when you are transported to the mother-daughter relationship that Shakuntala has with her daughter. Theek hai, Anu Menon, I understand you want to draw parallels between these two stories. But please be a little consistent. I am watching all that mathematics grow. I am getting invested. Okay, I'm a mathematics student. Isliye shayad I was getting invested. A lot of people might find it boring as well. Fuck it. Alright. I was getting invested. I was feeling interested in that story. Don't cut it suddenly just to show ke oh ho ho unka relationship kitna kharab tha. Or now coming to present to show ke in dono ka relationship bhi usi tarah fucked up hai. I won't buy it. I won't take it. And that is what constantly happens. There's a lot of back and forth. The movie starts somewhere in 1920s, 30s and spans till somewhere around 2000s. And there's constant back and forth that keeps on happening in the film. I think a lot of films have done this back and forth, but there's a way to do it which makes it more flowy and more interesting. That is where Anu Menon fails, because what happens is that it seems as if she just read out facts about Shakuntala Devi and whatever she probably heard from her daughter while scripting the film. Ke hua kya ke she just listed down events. Achha, 1920s mein ye hua tha, 30s mein hua tha, 40s mein hua tha, etc, etc, etc. Jo similar the unko ikatthe dal dete hain, unke scene ko ikatha edit kar denge. Jo alag alag hai unko alag alag rakhenge. And she just put them all together into a churner and what comes out is a khichdi. A khichdi that's not extremely tasty. Not tasty itself. And oh my god, Vidya Balan literally gives it out in a dialogue what really holds very strongly for this film, that we Indians cannot survive without drama. And Anu Menon takes it too seriously. The film is way too dramatic. And it seems to get so dramatic ke more than the Indians, it's actually the foreigners didn't say you expect more drama. Like literally there's this scene where Shakuntala is in London and she's talking to this lady at a school and the lady goes like, let me quote it. Are you talking stupid? my girls who come from all around the world, do you think I will introduce them to your mumbo jumbo? I'm sorry, I did it really bad, but yeah, this is kind of what it is. It's in the second half that the film moves a lot into the emotional melodrama portion, where the mother-daughter relationship is what becomes the central focus of the movie. And the major tear starts coming in there, that she wants to be a good mother, but she is extremely ambitious. The very much touched topic about being a lady. And that is what the film carries forward with in the second half. Too much melodrama, but I won't deny that just because of the performances, just lauding it to the performances, that towards the end, the climax, which is so heavily melodramatic, feels emotional because of Vidya Balan and Sanya Malhotra. And Vidya Balan is truly the life of the film. I think that would have been expected, because Vidya Balan owns every film she is in. If wo nahi hoti, to this would have been shit. Alright, real shit. But she lifts it to some level, and yeah, I'm pretty happy about that. But the problem is that just because Vidya Balan is so good, I feel that Sanya Malhotra won't be able to take away any credit for what she has done. But Sanya Malhotra is awesome. She is awesome. She nails whatever she has in her hands, and her role has enough meat, is what I would say as well. And I understand that when you're making such a film, you don't want your film necessarily to look like a documentary, because it's a biopic. So you may want to add some elements that it looks more slice of life and more interesting. But then just don't be so surface level and so flaky with what you're showing. At least mujhe mere main character mein invest to karne do. Unke saath to mujhe ek emotional connection banane do. Unfortunately, I did not feel once for Shakuntala Devi. I did not feel once for anything actually. So I think cutting the clutter, let me just be very clear that this film works in portions. Alright, probably the best because of its performances, everybody is good. There are portions, especially the mathematical parts, which might be extremely fascinating. They were for me, because I was like, how is she doing it? How the hell is this happening? But that is not enough to give you a fulfilling experience. So overall, this film just never works. But theek hai, ghar pe vele baithe ho, quarantine chal raha hai. Vidya Balan achhi acting karti hai. Movie theek hai, thoda maths ka dekh to loge. I don't think it's a harmful piece of work. Watch it. I'm going with 2.5 out of 5.
Maths mein rules nahi hai, sirf jadoo hai. Taiyar ho mere best friend maths se dosti karne ke liye?
And guys, there are these two more movies that I'm planning to review. One is Loot Case, which came out on Hotstar, and the other one is Raat Akeli Hai, which came out on Netflix. Tell me which one do you want me to review pehle, and put them down in the comments. And comments mein ye bhi likh dena ki ye wala review kaisa laga, because I think I'm very open to feedback. Also, देश में अनलॉक की प्रक्रिया शुरू हो चुकी है, पर उसका ये मतलब नहीं है आप लोग घर से बाहर भागना शुरू करते हैं. So please be home, be safe, try to quarantine yourself. And yeah, and please follow me on Instagram. I am there by the handle name of Sakshay Bhatia. I do tend to post some really quirky and weird stuff. So yeah, follow me.